Good morning, Eisenhower. Teachers, please get your laptops ready for today's UTV quiz.
I'm your host, Ashley, along with
Elizabetta. Today is October 9, Day A.
Today in history, on October 9, 1824, slavery is abolished in Costa Rica.
Please rise for the pledge.
You may be seated. The ETV quiz question is, in what year did the Mickey Mouse Club debut on ABC?
And now for today's announcements with Leah and Michael.
Good morning, I'm Leah, along with
Michael.
What does today's weather look like?
Today's sunny and partly cloudy, high is 68. Tonight, some passing clouds, low 44. Tomorrow, partly cloudy skies during the morning hours will become overcast in the afternoon, high 64. And now here's Leah with the rest of today's announcements.
Thank you, Michael. It's here, the winter play is finally here. Auditions for this year's winter play will be Tuesday, October 14th and Wednesday, October 15th at 3 p.m. in the multipurpose room, not the 7th and 8th as previously announced. We are looking for actors, stage crew, art crew, and anyone else who would like to be part of the fun. The winter play is open to all EMS students. Come on, come all. Please pick up an information packet in the front office or in Mr. Levy's room. Remember, the information packet must be read and filled out prior to your audition. A splendid time is guaranteed for all. Do you have strong opinions about controversial topics? Would you like to become an argumentative assassin, striking down your intellectual foes with rock-solid logic? Then come join the debate club. Mr. W is hosting the first meeting of this exciting new club on Wednesday, October 15th, right after school in room 506. Bring your A-game. Have you ever wanted to connect with the students from different cultures around the world? Wait no longer. Mr. W is hosting the Going Global Club this Tuesday, October 14th, right after school in room 506. Bring an open mind and a desire to interact with the world. The girls' soccer team's red ball went missing after the game on Tuesday. If found, please return to Ms. DeFiore in room 505. Attention student council members, don't forget to sell cookies. The Miss Fields cookie sale is underway. We are hoping to raise a lot of money for our council and charity to be able to support our events. If you need another order form, please stop by Miss Prado or Miss Caputo's room. And here's Michael with the rest of the day's announcements.
Thank you, Leah. Are you ready for the ultimate game? It's big, it's bold, and it's extreme. The wrecking ball is coming to EMS. Don't miss the chance to hurl the wrecking ball at your opponents and see who will be the last one standing. Be there this Friday at 7:30 p.m. Have your parent or guardian register you for the canteen by visiting the PTO website. Come with your friends and find out if you have what it takes to be the last one standing. On Thursday, October 16th, the library is hosting Allison Fermento's writing and publishing teen novels, a panel discussion in the Schottmeyer Room, open to tweens, teens, and adults from Wyckoff and local towns. Books will be sold at this function. All programs are open to all local tweens and teens. Registration is required. You may register at wyckofflibrary.org on our events calendar. Please do. Or contact Barbara at the library, 201-891-4866. The first rehearsal for the Eisenhower Jazz Band will be today at 3 p.m. in the band room. All students selected to participate must attend. The student council will have a snack sale during lunch periods on the minimum day Monday, October 13th. We will be selling water and snacks like chips and fruit snacks. All items are $1. Please bring small bills. Is Eisenhower celebrating any birthdays today?
Eisenhower wishes a very happy birthday to Elizabeth in 7H, Simone in 7J, Vincent in 7F, Sarika in 8J, Gannon in 6L, and Isabella in 7M. What's for lunch today?
Today's lunch is build your own panini with a cup of soup. What's tomorrow's lunch?
Tomorrow's lunch is Pizza Parlor Pizza. What's in the headlines?
Federal health officials will require temperature checks for the first time at 5 major American airports for people arriving from 3 West African countries, countries hardest hit by the deadly Ebola virus. And now today's feature with Nicole and Emma.
Thanks, Leah and Michael.
Nicole, do you remember when you were in 6th grade trying lunch for the first time?
Yeah, I thought it was better than my elementary school.
Same. Now let's go see what 6th graders think about Eisenhower lunch.
Hey there, Eisenhower. We are here to interview the 6th graders about school lunch. In elementary school, students ordered online every month from Nicholas Markets, Parkwood Deli, and Westside Bagels, and they would deliver it to your school.
Now students have an account with Pomptanian Food Service, and you can find the menu online. Students can get anything from deli, hot lunch, snacks, bagels, and salad bar.
Is it better or worse? Let's go find out.
What's better about Eisenhower lunch?
At Eisenhower lunch, you get to buy your food, and you have your own choices.
What's different about Eisenhower lunch than your elementary school lunch?
Well, we have a lot of choices, and we get to sit wherever we want.
Do you like it better or worse than your elementary school?
I think it's better.
What school did you go to?
Washington.
What food do you miss that Eisenhower doesn't have?
Well, we had like spicy hot chips, I guess.
And do you like that you get to sit with your friends now?
Yes, because we had to sit with like our class in elementary school, so.
What do you not like about Eisenhower lunch?
It's really crowded during lunch. And it has really long lines.
Thank you.
Elijah, what's different about Washington school lunch and Eisenhower lunch?
You can order your lunch here and you had to bring your lunch at Washington.
In other elementary schools, you got to order your lunch online. You couldn't do that at Washington?
No.
What school did you go to?
Washington.
What do you like better about Eisenhower lunch than your elementary school?
There's a lot more food options.
Thank you. Whether it's hot lunch or deli, it seems like 6th graders like Eisenhower lunch better.
And now back to our hosts, Elizabetta
and Ashley.
Thank you, Emma and Nicole. The answer to today's ETV quiz is 1955. The winning homerooms are
there are no winners in second and third place, but Mr. DeLockery came in first place. This teacher's homeroom will be featured on an ETV closing video. And now for the joke of the day.
How does the man on the moon cut his hair?
How?
Eclipse it. Thanks for watching, Eisenhower.
Have a thrilling Thursday.